Look up to an example on how to use paper folding to model the addition of fractions with different denominators. Let's consider the sum of 1/2 and 1/3. Let's first define one sheet of paper as one whole, and now we'll model 1/2 using this sheet of paper and 1/3 using this sheet of paper. To model the fraction of 1/2, we want to fold the paper so that we have two equal sized sections, or two equal sized pieces. So let's make one fold vertically, which would look like this. So if we fold the paper vertically here, notice how we now have two equal sized sections. And because the numerator is 1 for the model for 1/2, we shade one of the two equal sized sections or equal sized pieces. So this is the model for 1/2. And now to emphasize the vocabulary of a fraction, remember the top number is the numerator and the bottom number is the denominator. So it's also correct to say, to model 1/2, we denominate one sheet of paper into two equal sections and shade one section because we are enumerating or counting one of the two sections. And now we'll use this sheet of paper to model 1/3. So because the denominator is 3, we need to fold the paper so that we have three equal sized sections or pieces. And for this sheet of paper, let's make the folds horizontally. So if we make a fold here and here, notice how we have three equal sized pieces or sections. And therefore, to model 1/3, we would shade one of the three pieces. So here's a model for 1/3. We can also say to model 1/3, we denominate one sheet of paper into three equal sections and shade one section because we are enumerating or counting one of the three sections. Now remember, our goal here is to add these two fractions, which means you want to combine these two amounts. But notice how, because the pieces are not the same size, we cannot tell how much the combined amount would be. We need to have pieces of the same size. To make pieces of the same size, we'll take the model for 1/2 and make two folds horizontally, just like we did to model the fraction of 1/3. So using the model for 1/2, we make a fold here and here, just like we did to model the fraction of 1/3. Notice this shows us the fraction of 1/2 equals 3/6. We now have six pieces, or six sections of the same size, and we have three of them shaded, which is the model for 3/6. We can say that 3/6 is equivalent to the fraction of 1/2. And now using the model for 1/3, we'll make one fold vertically, just like we did to model the fraction of 1/2. So we make a fold here, and notice how this shows us that 1/3 is equivalent to 2/6. Also notice how now all of the pieces are the same size, and therefore we can combine the two amounts and determine how much we have. Notice that 3/6 plus 2/6 is equal to 5/6. We have a total of three pieces plus two pieces, which gives us five pieces, where each piece is 1/6 of a whole, and therefore the sum of 1/2 and 1/3 is equal to 3/6 plus 2/6, which equals 5/6. I hope you found this helpful.